JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for September the 18th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar traded lower against all the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It underperformed the least against Kiwi, SEC, Aussie, and the Euro in that order, while it lost the least ground versus the pound and the yen. Now, the weakening of the dollar and the yen suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday. However, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that this was not the case. Major EU and US indices were a sea of red, with the financial and technology sectors being hit the most. That said, investors' appetite improved during the Asian session today, with both Japan's Nikkei 225 and China's Shanghai Composite gaining 0.12 and 1.69% respectively. It seems that equities continue to slide in the aftermath of a less dovish than expected Fed. Remember that on Wednesday, the committee decided to keep interest rates unchanged within the 0 to 0.25% range. And although they said that they remain ready to adjust their policy if economic conditions change, there were no hints of a fresh stimulus in the foreseeable future, with Fed Chair Jerome Powell noting that the current policy stance remains appropriate. On top of that, the median dots of the new dot plot suggested that interest rates are likely to stay at current levels at least through 2023. But looking at the details, we see that four members were in favor of higher rates in 2023, despite the inflation forecast of the year staying only at 2%. This means that not all participants are willing to tolerate above target inflation before they start raising interest rates. As we noted yesterday, equities may continue to slide as investors digest the decision or due to profit taking after the steep rally in tech-related stocks. The absence of hints of a fresh monetary stimulus, combined with the absence of any accord between the US government and the Congress over new fiscal support, may keep equities pressured for a while more. However, the Fed's readiness to do more if deemed necessary may keep any further losses limited. We stick to our guns that the extra loose monetary policy around the globe, combined with positive headlines surrounding a potential vaccine, may eventually help equities to rebound and keep the US dollar under selling interest. Now, speaking about monetary policy, yesterday we had a Bank of England decision. This bank decided to keep its policy untouched via unanimous vote, but noted that it is exploring how a negative bank rate could be implemented effectively. Officials also noted that the economy looks unusually uncertain and that the Monetary Policy Committee will consider issues relating to Brexit within the context of its wider forecast discussions ahead of the November MPC meeting. Now, cable slipped around 100 pips at the time of the release, as the bank now appears to be talking more openly about negative rates, with the chances of any EU-UK trade deal before the October 15th deadline being very slim due to tensions between the two sides. Investors may have now increased their bets that the bank could proceed with pushing the cut button at one of its upcoming gatherings. Moving ahead, the rising probabilities of a no-deal Brexit at the end of the year and a potential rate cut into negative waters may keep the pound under selling interest. Now, as for today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK retail sales for August. Both the headline and core rates declined notably, but less than the forecasts suggested. In any case, the pound barely reacted to this release, with its traders staying focused on the prospect of negative rates by the Bank of England and the slim chances of a trade deal between the UK and the EU. We get retail sales from Canada as well, but for July, while from the US we have the preliminary University of Michigan Consumer Sentiment Index for September. Canada's retail sales are also expected to have slowed notably after skyrocketing in June, while the University of Michigan Index is expected to have increased to 75 from 74.1. As for the speakers, we have two on today's schedule, and those are ECB Vice President Luis de Guindos and ECB Executive Board Member Isabel Schnabel. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.